My name is Professor Susan Lanham-New. I head up the Department of Nutritional Sciences at the University of Surrey, and I'm also Professor of Human Nutrition, and my research area is that of diet and musculoskeletal health with a focus on vitamin D. Vitamin D is an extraordinary nutrient, and it's something that we've been working on at the University of Surrey for over 15 years. Up until 2016, the government didn't make any recommendations that we should have vitamin D in our diet because it was deemed that we got enough from the sunlight to last us in the summer to then last us during the winter. We did one of the first studies to look at how much diet and sunlight exposure contributed to vitamin D status, and this was funded by the UK government, and it provided key evidence that thinking that we made enough vitamin D during the summer to last us during the winter was actually scientifically inaccurate. What we then did was to pull together a number of key population studies. We worked very closely with the University of Manchester to measure accurately vitamin D status in these population groups. And we disseminated this work very widely to Her Majesty's government, both to the Scientific Advisory Committee on Nutrition, the Department of Health, and the UK Food Standards Agency. Those publications then led the government to agree to a full risk assessment of vitamin D to show how much vitamin D that we should try to gain in our diet in order to achieve the right vitamin D levels. For us to be in good health and good mobility, we need vitamin D. But we also now know that it's important in other key health outcomes, including upper respiratory tract infection preventions and other health conditions. Our work with the food industry has meant that they've been able to have strong scientific evidence for the form of vitamin D that they put into their products and the amount of vitamin D that they need to put into those products in order to help individuals to then achieve a much higher level of vitamin D status. What we're trying to do is to improve the health of the UK population through ensuring that all population groups, irrespective of their ethnicity, ensure that their vitamin D levels are suffice, i.e. that they have enough vitamin D circulating in their bodies at whatever age they are. And we know that vitamin D is very important in growing children. The recommendation from the government, I think, has given a much wider exposure and media highlight to the importance of vitamin D.